Alright folks, Jonathan here. In this tutorial we're going to be looking at a feature which is known as the roll feature. You do find it on quite a few mixers, modern day mixers. Just to let you know as well, the track we're going to be using is on King Street. It's Roland Clark presents Urban Soul, and it's a track entitled If I Was a DJ. Now a lot of people will use the roll feature anywhere. They'll just mess around with it and they won't experiment. But by actually experimenting and trying to hit that roll button at the right time can make it sound fantastic. Now first of all, what we've done, we've set the mixer here to roll. We've got this dial here set to number 2 because this dial will determine which channel we're going to actually set this effect to. The vinyl turntable is on channel 2, so this dial is set to channel 2. Now when we press this button here, what will happen is we will actually get the effect in motion. Now what we've got here, we've got an area whereby we can see a readout. Now when we've got this red mark here, if I just go close up now, if I just wang that there, you've seen the turntable now. So if I go close up, it will give you a better idea of the area we need to look at. You can see there, we've got a red block that's centre position. Now when that is centre position, it means we will get 1/1 sampling. In other words, we will hear the sample in one section. If I just start music, have a listen. So basically, we've got one beat. In other words, in the middle, one beat. If we flip it over to 1/2, we will actually get half that amount of sample we had when it was at 1/1. Have a listen. And then when we flip it over again to 1/4, we'll get a quarter of that sample. Have a listen. And then if we go over to 1/8, we'll get an eighth of that sample. Now also, people have said, well, can you only use this on CDJs? Well, there's your answer. Okay, and also, if we go to 2/1, this is what happens. And then if we go to 4/1, have a listen. So basically what's happening, not only is the roll feature acting as a roll, it's actually acting as a loop sampler. Okay, here's the deal. This is where we can actually experiment and take this effect from just messing around to the next dimension. Now a lot of people will hit that sampler button when we hear the bass beat, boom, boom, boom. But also you can hit it on the high beat, boom, cha, boom, cha, here, boom, cha, boom, cha. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to now give you a demonstration and actually talk you through the demonstration while we're doing it. So I'll put the needle back onto the sort of the beginning of the track. Okay, at the moment now we're 1/1. Now what I'm going to do, alright, let's start it right from the beginning. First of all, I'm going to press the button on the bass beat. You're only going to hear the actual jump, chicka jump, chicka jump, chicka jump, but I'm going to hit it on the jump. And then I'm going to hit on the chack. So boom, hit it there, and then the ch, hit it at the top. Let's hear the difference. Here we go. And one. That's the bass kick. The high kick. So we're alternating, even though it's a very subtle difference, it does sound a lot better to change. Let's put the track halfway through. Now again, this is 1/1. Now, two things are happening. One is I'm listening to the bars. When I press that button, I'm actually counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. So as soon as I hit that button again, it goes out of that roll and it comes back into the original music, therefore keeping the continuity. Now what I'm going to do, we're going to go to 1/2. In other words, we're going to have half the sample, and I'll do near enough exactly the same thing, but I will also hit that button on the bass beat, like I said earlier, and then I'll also hit that button on the high beat. Let's hear the difference. Now high beat. And there you go. So we had two separate ways of hitting, well, when I say two separate ways of hitting the button, we hit it exactly the same. You hit it and we get a sample, but I hit it on the bass beat the first time, and then the second time I hit it on the high treble beat, and the telephone's going. Hold on a second. Okay, so there we go, we've done, by the way, I'm back, I just went the phone. So there we go, we've done the 1/1, which was like so, and we've done a half beat. Now we'll do a quarter beat. And again, do it on the bass beat and also on the high beat. Alright, now, while I was doing that, I was counting. Now, I know it's very difficult to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 like that, but it's almost, you'll get used to it and you'll hear the beats automatically. Now, I have broached on this subject before, I'm sure, about the roll feature. But again, it's all about experimenting. Now, if you count with your fingers, messing around with the 1/1, 2/1, and then the 1/2, and the 1/8, 1/4. In other words, we're going to get one beat, we're going to get two beats, or we're going to get half a beat, quarter, or eighth. We can alternate between all of those, and we can make the track sound a lot more interesting. So we'll try that now. Also, you've got to remember the structure of the music, the bars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. There you go. So there you go. It's all about, yeah, what is that? It's all about having fun and experimenting. Don't forget, the more you practice, the better you'll get. And by the way, practice and enjoy. I had to get it. It was $1 from America. Bye.